Hi there, I'm Lynn Morgan, and I'm a pastel artist, and I'd like to welcome you to my studio. Okay, let's talk about underpaintings today. I'm all set up here to do an underpainting. I've got my easel on top of my easel air equipment, and my UART paper taped to the easel. And for my underpaintings, I usually use my hard pastels. So I have here my full set of new pastel, hard pastels, and I also have a set of Mungyo Gallery pastels, which I like. They're not as hard as the new pastels, but they're quite nice, and they have very bright colors, and I like them. And then I also have a set of Giraud darks, and these are not quite as soft as the, as hard as the new pastels either, but they are very nice darks. And in my underpaintings, the most important thing that I'm trying to do is kind of get my value pattern established. Okay, I'm ready to get started now, and I have my, I'm working from a photo here, and I'm going to try to put in some of my darks. It doesn't really matter what color I use at this point because it's going to be covered up to a great extent. And I'm trying to make this a little bit abstract, so I'm not trying to follow the photo particularly, but it's giving me my inspiration here. So here we go. And I'll show you what I'm going to do with this after I finish doing this. You'll notice I'm wearing a glove, and I also have some of my favorite music playing in the background, which just happens to be classic rock. I want to get these darks in pretty good and solid, and take a look at that. I also like to get in some of my other colors, and sometimes I use local color and sometimes I use something completely opposite from the local color. So I'm just going to put in a little bit of whites in through here. Working pretty loosely. And my background is going to be a lighter color because I want to show a little atmospheric perspective on this. Something light up here to sort of represent the sky. Okay, basically that's all there is to it for the underpainting, and then I'll show you what I'm going to do next. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do to my underpainting is I'm going to take some denatured alcohol, and this little brush is just a little chip brush from Home Depot that I cut off, and it's actually gotten worn down practically to a nub. I think it's probably about time for a new one, but that's okay. This is denatured alcohol. Sometimes I use water, I like water because it gives a nice drippy effect, but it also buckles the paper a lot more than the denatured alcohol does. The denatured alcohol dries very quickly, and it spreads the pastel around on the tooth of the paper to give me just some nice basic under color. So I'm going to start with the lightest areas first. There's a little bit of drip with this, but not as much because it dries so fast. There's not as much as there is when you use water. Again, this is still an underpainting, so I'm not terribly concerned about exactly how the shapes come out, because I'm going to paint over most of this. But I might let some of this underpainting show through, because I do like these colors. Yes, I think it's definitely time for a new brush. This still works. It's just a little bit harder than I would like. But again, that's okay. You can see how if I put a lot of liquid, it starts to drip a little bit. And it definitely gives me a little bit of a drippy effect. If I had a longer bristle brush, it would be more drippy, I think. That's why I have to keep dipping the brush in here too, because there's so few bristles that it won't really hold very much. This paper, this UART paper, it's a sandpaper, and so it really does eat up the brush, and that's why I use a very inexpensive brush. I wouldn't want to use any of my good brushes for this purpose, because they would be ruined in no time at all. I could actually paint over this with some more underpainting after I'm finished, but I don't usually find it necessary to do that. Some of these strokes, when they show through the painting on the top, will actually be quite nice. And you can see that I'm going pretty fast here and doing it very roughly. So they'll be fairly abstract, which is really what I want. I really want to set this pastel into the tooth, because that gives me the opportunity to put as much or as little pastel over it as I determine is appropriate as I start painting. I do care about the strokes here, because they might show through a little bit too, but it's not that big of a deal, really. Okay. That pretty much takes care of the underpainting.